coaching a low performer and a high performer. If an employee is a low performer, there can be two reasons. The job or part of the job is new for the employee, and the employee is learning and is not yet up in speed. The employee has been in the job for long and is for some reason not living up to expectations. If the employee is new in the job, or if there has been changes to the job and the employee has got new tasks to do, this person needs your support as a manager. Coaching is a better tool to use as a starting point. It may be so that you need to show how things are done too. Ask questions like, what have you succeeded with so far? What are you mostly proud of? What have been challenging to you? What have you done so far to deal with your challenges? What do you need going forward to be able to handle your challenges? What are your learning goals for the next period? What do you think you are able to do once you have reached your learning goals? How are you going to work with your learning goals? What will that mean for the business goals? How can I best support you in the coming period? Add your feedback on what you have seen this person is able to do. If the employee has been in the job for long and still not living up to expectations, you need to ask yourself a couple of questions before you coach the employee. Many managers believe that it's enough to communicate expectations in general or insinuate what the expectations are. These managers often get frustrated by the lack of performance and tend to get irritated when being with the employee and usually discuss the employee with others. The good advice is to communicate the expectations concrete and with examples of how you want it to be. At the same time, set learning goals together with the employee and discuss successes and challenges at every monthly meeting and train the employee on the job where you can see the person in action. This will give you an opportunity to give valuable feedback. If you are that close to your employee, you will know within a few months if this person is able to do the job or if another job is a better match. Ask yourself these questions. How clear have I communicated the goals, expectations, and consequences? How clear have I set a deadline? What have I done to help the person succeed? How many times have I asked valuable questions to the employee to help the employee find the way to meet expectations? How much have I supervised and given feedback to the person on the job? How have I helped the person to set learning goals to continuously improve? How often have I followed up on the learning goals? How fast have I initiated support to get the employee back on track according to the learning goals? If you're already close to the employee, these questions can be helpful for you to ask the employee. Now that you know what is expected of you, what is your plan to reach the goals? What are you already able to do that will support you? What is challenging for you? Ask more questions to discover what the lack of performance is really all about. It could be technical skills, practical skills, training, courage, or other things holding back the employee. How will your work life look like once you have met your goals? How important is it for you? What will that mean for you? How will it look like if you're not going to meet the goals? What do you want to do now? What is your first easy step? What is your first difficult step? When are you going to take those steps? When can you see the outcome of those steps? What more do you need to do? How will these steps help you meet the goals? What is your proof that you are progressing? What will you do if this is not working for you? What kind of support do you need from now on? If you give another deadline, make sure that you believe that this person will succeed and that there is a solid plan. If you believe, then say it out loud. I believe that you can do it, and I believe you have a good plan. Continue to be close and give feedback on the job and follow up in monthly meetings. If both of you can see that there is no plan and will never be a good plan to move forward, then it's time to front the reality. The job and the person is not a good match. Once that has been stated, continue by asking these questions. What is mostly exciting in the job you do now? What is missing in your job? If you could choose how your job should look like, how should it be? Where can you find such a job? How can I best help you to find the place where your special talents can flourish? If you have been close to the employee setting a clear direction and the person still believes that he or she can live up to expectations and still there is no clear plan, maybe it's time for you to decide upon what is the right team for you. Start by asking yourself if your goals are set too high. If not, then you can ask questions like, now that you know that my opinion is that your talents lies in another job than this and that I cannot give you any more time to meet the goals, how can I best support you to find another job? This can be hard and still it is necessary. Be hard on the task and soft on the people, meaning that you are hired to deliver with your team so the goals must be clear and the team has to deliver. At the same time, you're responsible for people's ability to move on if you have not set the right team from the beginning. Coaching a high performer can be a challenge for a manager. Every person wants to be even better, and a high performer most probably wants to stay on top. To stay on top, you need to improve. If not, someone will challenge your position sooner or later. If a high performer is not constantly on the move, there's a risk of that person ending as an average or a low performer. The reason can be that the person is finding challenges elsewhere and not staying focused on the job, getting a bit lazy because of being used to being the best. The challenge for you as a manager can be that you do not believe that this person can be any better and that you do not have any answers to where that person can be better. Any person can be better, and remember that you're not the expert on the employee's job. Let the employee be the expert and ask questions like, if you should be even better than you are already, what should you then improve? If you should find a way to figure out what you can improve to stay as a high performer, how would you do that? The team has an average goal, and I believe that with your skills, you can do 20% better. What do you say about that? Find learning objectives for a high performer as well as you do for a low performer. That gives you a reason to celebrate and to get much more than you expect. Set individual high goals for a high performer, and you will see that they have a reason to give it the extra. If they are satisfied with an average goal, then tell them that you believe that they are able to reach higher. Help people to shine for a long time. Your employee will not thank you in the long run to have lost focus on his or her development. If the employee is not progressing over time, he or she might end up being irrelevant. There is only one constant factor, and that is change. Every change gives a new opportunity to develop. If you and your employee cannot find a way for the person to improve in the moment, maybe this person is the one being in charge of supporting others to improve. What a lot of managers are often forgetting is that high performers need focus too. If you do not know who your high performers is, then you might have concentrated too much on your low performers. If high performers do not get attention and focus, there's a risk that they will start questioning whether or not they live up to expectations. Be sure to tell them that they do and how they do it.